Good morning. Happy 4th of July. I'm Barbara Adrianopoli.
Hi, and I'm Debbie Miller, and we're here to give you a play-by-play on the floats as they come by.
This is the 50th annual 4th of July parade for the village of Hoffman Estates. And Debbie, you remember this area when you first moved in here.
Yes, we were original owners down on Rosedale near where Eisenhower School is now. And Hassel Road at that time was a two-lane, like a gravel or stone road just to get to the farms. And look at it now.
Oh, yeah. This is the police color guard led by Lieutenant Paez. And then we have the vehicles behind them, Deb.
Oh, yeah. But Lieutenant Paez did a wonderful job for the Hoffman Estates Museum a couple of years ago when we showcased the police department.
Right.
He told us about all the stuff that was there.
Now, we're going to kind of be a little quieter to let our fire trucks make all the noise, okay? Well, just watch. But, I love it. Look at down the road, the audience is... they're squirting the firemen with water this time instead of opposite.
And along with the police department are the sheriff's department. And every year, I think it's the month of January, the sheriff brings inmates who are on helping the community patrol to come and wash cars at the township hall.
Here we go. Isn't that fun? Oh, this is beautiful. Love the clapping. Sheriff John Dart's a car is in this parade too with the fellow policeman. This is the DARE car.
Yes.
That they picked up with from drug dealers. It'd be fun to drive that one. Fire department color guard here.
And their hatchets are bright and shiny.
The color guard there. And this is the fire chief.
Must be the fire chief.
Yes, it's the new fire chief.
Those are the people you don't want to see except in parades.
I just love this. We have fire trucks from throughout the communities. East Dundee Fire Department, they're always here for us.
And I've had personal experience using the ambulances from the Hoffman Estates Fire Department, and they have been just extraordinary.
Schaumburg Fire Department coming up.
Isn't it amazing how their trucks are all bright and shiny?
Beautiful. Another Hoffman Estates, big one now.
Yeah, that's
the higher buildings.
That's the one with the ladders, isn't it, Barbara?
Right, for our new taller buildings. Then we have the 1950 Ford Rescue Squad from Dennis Clossing that you're going to see right now in your picture.
That's an old one.
A 1950 Rescue Squad.
That was truck number one.
Yes, and the Cook County Sheriff, John Dart's entries. They always have wonderful music, don't they?
Yes, and Tom Dart's been a wonderful sheriff.
I love that car. Now in your picture, you're
going to...
Yes, aren't they wonderful? You're going to see some of the children that were part of the bicycle units. I wonder who won. Every year they have bicycle and tricycle entries. Oh, there's a little darling that just fell off his skateboard. But they win a prize. Now we have Redmond Towing that's coming up. And Redmond Towing is the official tow trucks of the village of Hoffman Estates. They were busy this morning towing cars along Hassel Road, weren't they?
Absolutely. And I think, if I'm not mistaken, they were the original tow trucks for the village.
Oh, when we first came in?
When the village was first established.
Well, the family has lived here. The Rogner family has lived here a long time.
I know. And they used to be in the gas station at Golf and Higgins. I mean, at Roselle and Higgins.
Right here, hi. Passing out lots of candy. The kids are going to love this. Yes. They've been here a long time. In order to be an official village towing company, they must be able to tow big vehicles, trucks, buses, all of that. And these, as you can see, the trucks going by certainly can tow big buses and big trucks. We have the... Following them, we have the
Arnold Heath Memorial VFW post. The VFW has served veterans in our area for as long as we have had Hoffman Estates and wars.
Oh, they're a wonderful group of people.
Yes, they are. I don't think most of us honor the veterans that served us as we should.
The other night at the at the Village Hall celebrations, there were a number of vets returning.
Oh, wonderful.
And they were given free drinks and everything, which was really nice.
Hi.
Wonderful. Behind them is the another American Legion post. It's Ellsworth Meineke.
And Ellsworth Meineke, the original Ellsworth Meineke, had a peony farm and wholesaled peonies all over the country. His farm was on near Higgins and Meacham.
I love peonies, don't you?
Yes,
they're
oh,
so
yes.
Beautiful. Listen to the crowd. Oh. They are appreciative.
And if you go to the Heritage Farm in Schaumburg, he donated the land for that and the cabin that's used and the museum in memory of his wife. This.
That's wonderful tribute.
This is the Ellsworth Meineke car.
Coming up, we have the Hoffman Estates Veterans Memorial Commission. Les Montague is the chairman of that department. It was really the push of former trustee Bruce Lynn who got this going. It was transferred from the old village hall now to the new fire department, police department in the village along Hassel Road there, where Santee's Restaurant used to be. It won a hometown award in 1989.
Isn't that lovely?
Yeah. And then behind them we have the...
Oh, the Grand Marshal. And this is the family of Scott Trippin, who died recently. He was a prime mover in the park district and its activities for many years, and a great friend and contributor to the village.
Then we have the new generation fancy drill team. And they are from Chicago.
Look at those uniforms, Barbara, the bright blue.
Oh, yes. They... Thank you.
so good.
They have won over 5 Midwest Regional Championships.
Wow.
And they're from, they've done the Lilac Festival, the Cheese Day Parade in Wisconsin.
The Bud Billiken Day Parade.
Yes, let's talk a little bit more about the Trepan family. Scott Trepan, who the marshal, who they're honoring with his family. He was a lifelong resident of Hoffman Estates. And now we have the Allegiance Color Guard.
And they're from East Dundee.
Oh, yes.
Oh, look at them, Barbara.
Oh, aren't they? They're ages 7 to 20. We miss the Bluecoats Drum and Bugle Corps from Canton, Ohio, too. And they were right after the drill team. Oh, and then we have, there's some more of the Allegiance.
Like it's their flag uniforms. Group, yeah.
Yeah, yeah. That's very hot, too. Look at the lady going around squirting their faces and the darling little one coming up the end here.
They're adorable children.
Yes, yes, yes. And then we have the Pediatric Brain Tumor Foundation, the Chicagoland Ride for Kids, and its motorcycles that are part of the parade group, helping to combat brain tumors.
Ride for Kids.
Very nice. Oh, they like it. Oh, that's very nice, isn't it? This is the first time they've been in our parade, haven't they? Isn't it, Deb?
Yes, it is. Yeah. That's a wonderful thing to do for children.
Oh, yes.
I can't imagine anything as drastic as giving birth to a child with brain deformities.
Yeah. And now the next parade group is coming up, and we see them. They're called the Paul Hall. The motorcycle is gunning the Paul Hall Boys and Girls Club Warriors Drum and Bugle Corps. They're from Chicago.
Yes.
Nice.
Look at the flags they have from all over. That's probably country of origin for some of those people.
They're from Elgin, right next door. A baton group, and they start very young. They've won state and regional titles, and you can tell they're quite good.
Oh my goodness, those gals are wonderful.
Look how little they are, too, and it's warm outside. That's really good.
And there's a little one walking in the parade in a stroller.
Now this is the New Generation Fancy Drill Team. Wonderful.
Oh, look at them.
Wonderful.
They're great. Wonderful. And just spacing this thing is tough.
Oh, look at the glad-handed giving fives to the crowd. Oh, look at the drummers, too. It's wonderful. And Fabrini flowers.
Oh,
thank you.
Good, thank you. The judges get a couple extra ones.
Oh, you're darling. Yes. Thank you. This is Fabrini flowers we're seeing now.
Kiss, huh? No, give it to me. Come on over here.
Thank you.
Same to you.
And that was our wonderful Fabrini flowers that are always here for us from Hoffman Estates. They hand out flowers every year, Debbie.
And they're one of the first businesses in the village.
Yes,
and they just moved to a new, bigger place. If you are in the market for flowers or for floral arrangements, you can't do any better than going to Fabrini.
And this is a Chicago Express hockey team that's coming up. They're new at the Sears Center. Then we have, coming behind them, is the Schaumburg Area Democrats, and Rocco Terranova is the committee man, and they have a sign for Raja, who's...
Raja Krishnamurthy is going to be a candidate for U.S. Congress from the new district.
And he's the one in the blue shirt there.
Yes.
Yes, and I see him. And Nolan, Senator Nolan is with that group. And,
yes.
And Representative Musman is there, too, on the right-hand side.
Yes.
And the committee people. Yes, yes. And Raja for Congress there. Bob Frankel is in the group.
Where is he?
No, I'm wrong.
I didn't see him. Who said that? Oh, hi!
Yeah. And Michael Nolan, his sign there.
Yeah.
And look at the young kids with there.
And
Michelle Musman's a group handing out candy, and her children are there.
And here's a Raja truck.
Coming up, we have the little girl who's Teen Illinois, and she's done such a nice job.
She looks so pretty.
Yeah,
she's got to be warm in that long dress.
She's always come out now for everything. You can see her.
It's Myrna.
This is a drum and bugle corps from Thomasville, Georgia. They're called the Teal Sound. Thomasville, Georgia.
And they have teal blue in their uniforms. Aren't they good?
Yes. From Tealville, Georgia. That's the longest way we've ever had. Now we're coming up with the Honey Bears. Chicago Honey Bears. And they're at the Sears Center too.
Oh, they're wonderful dancers. Look at those ladies.
They originated from the Chicago Bears and now perform country's hottest full production. Well, you have to have a lot of high energy, don't you?
Oh, yes. I don't think I could do it at their age either.
Yeah. 23 of the state fairs they've performed at, including the Illinois State Fair. And they're the number one entertainment act in the fair industry. I didn't know that. That's really
And they're
great.
Also the number one entertainment act for our U.S. military.
Oh, wow. They have performed in Japan for the annual Christmas tour at the Japanese orphanages. Oh, that was wonderful.
They are great. And now here's the Shriners, the Dressers Shrine Club from Rockford, Illinois.
And their president is Walt Lockhart.
And here are some of their motorcycles.
And they raise funds. They join the parades to raise funds for over 22 hospitals because the children can go to these hospitals free of charge.
Especially their burn hospitals.
Yes.
They're wonderful.
They're noted for that. And any child can come for free, which is a wonderful, wonderful gift. Okay, now here we have, in the float, we have the Village of Hoffman Estates, the Parade Marshal, Pam Sampson. Now, Pam Sampson was one of the great, she just retired, principals. She was at Armstrong School, Keller Junior High. We have coming up too, we have the Wesley Williams, and he's gonna be the piper for the mayor. Yes. And the mayor brought him. He does the part of the Tartan Day Parade.
Yeah. Mayor McLeod comes from Scottish ancestry, and he never misses an opportunity to show their beautiful, beautiful musical skills to the village residents.
And his name is Wesley Williams, who is the bagpiper for the mayor. Isn't that nice? I love
bagpipe music.
Oh, I do too. Yeah.
At one time, my husband wanted to learn, so we bought him a practice pipe, but he found it was too difficult.
Oh, you really have to be able to breathe.
Oh, yeah.
And behind them is...
And if I'm not mistaken, excuse me, he's in McLeod Tartan.
Yes.
And behind him is the Grupo Folklorico. Oh, that's the Board of Education.
The District 54.
District 54.
But you're right about the Grupo.
Yeah. And they've got that car all decorated up.
And the wonderful little dancers from the group. They are from Hanover Park, and they do all kinds of festivals, and the little girls and boys do native dances from Mexico.
From the state of Jalisco, or Jalisco in Mexico, and their costumes are authentic. And those skirts are magnificent. Look at the girls twirl.
How beautiful they are. And the little ones in the back of them.
And is that Assistant Mayor McLeod.
Yes.
And there we have Mayor McLeod in his tartan, greeting all the people, walking across and greeting all the people.
He got behind his bagpiper greeting everybody.
Oh, and he's throwing candy to the kids. Yeah. Isn't that lovely?
Yeah.
How many communities have a mayor that comes out in a parade and throws candy to the kids
exactly.
and talks to them?
Exactly. Here's our village board there.
Is that the village board?
No, this is not. Hope Means Life church and community.
That's a church group, yes.
This is Hope Pet Rescue. And
now, these
are the dogs that are up for adoption, everybody.
And if you want a pet,
rescue.
If you want a pet, I urge you, please, to rescue a pet. PetSmart has pets available all the time. We got our cat from a rescue, and he's been a wonderful, wonderful pet for the last 12 years.
And now this is Gigi's Playhouse, and Gigi's Playhouse is a wonderful group that is for Down syndrome children.
And any other mentally disabled kids. It's a playhouse for them to learn.
Educational and social group. And it was started by volunteers who started it. See, it's a really a wonderful place.
They're an asset to the village.
We have the village commissioners now handing out candy. I see Bev Romanoff, our village clerk over here. I see
yes.
Karen Mills, Ann Palafis, and Jackie Green.
Gary Palafis.
All of the people. Anna Newell, who's also a trustee.
Yes, and she's throwing candy at all the kids.
Yes.
And across the street is Ray Kincaid.
And Joan McLeod is on the truck here throwing candy. Here, now they're getting going. Those are our trustees in the village of Hoffman.
Hey!
Okay. Then we have the McCarthy School of Dance right behind them.
From Scottish to Irish. We've gone from Scottish to Irish. Lovely young lady.
Aren't they darling?
The sun is on the power of love, and I wish that I could be ready. Because I know it will be some long, long time before we see the end.
And we forgot Ray Kincaid. He's here now, our village trustee. This is the Midwest Elite. Oh, thank you. He just gave us some flags. Our trustee, Ray Kincaid. And we had the Motive, Encourage, Guide, and Achieve. It's the Midwest Elite Gymnastic Academy.
That is so good for kids.
They're from South Barrington.
Which is just our neighbors. Mega.
So, how's it going?
They have their own little truck talking about the academy.
Go back one harbor. No.
Mm-hmm.
Ladies and gentlemen, happy 4th of July.
This is
the 2010-2011 competitive gymnasts from Midwest Elite Gymnastics Academy. They rock!
They have their own little MC guy.
Look at all these beautiful kids out here in the hot sun with microphone feedback. In this group of kids, there are 17 state champions. At the rear of this group, there's an entire group of boys, the Illinois State Level 4 champions. They're awesome.
Oh, they are.
But they wanted to come out here, play some really loud music, and say Happy 4th of July. Happy 4th of July, everybody!
This is the first time that group has entered our... Look
and
at these
so
young
good.
Men.
Look at the kids doing cartwheels and stuff.
Oh, wow.
Hey, it's okay to dance if you want to.
Oh. Wow.
Look at him.
Oh. Wonderful. What a group of talented young people.
Oh, yes.
We've had some very nice, nice entertainment in this parade. Now we have PAC 100 from Fairview and Hoffman Estates.
They're the oldest Cub Scout group in the village.
50 plus years, like you said. Twinbrook School was the first elementary school built in the village of Hoffman Estates. Oh, look at that wonderful float. Isn't it a wonderful float?
Look at the Abraham Lincoln on the float.
And the Statue of Liberty and George Washington, Martha Washington.
Oh, wonderful.
Yeah. And then at the end, they have President Obama, yet Lincoln. Oh, wonderful.
And here's PAC 290 right behind them.
Oh, yes. We have the Wooddale Fire Department coming now, along with another Cub Scout group, 290. Very nice.
And the sign on it says, "We support 863, I can't read it.
Army Division. Oh, they have some of the people that have gone to the war in Afghanistan and Iraq. And they have the pictures of some of the soldiers who passed away.
And behind, right there is Cub Scout PAC 297.
And that's from Hanover Park.
Our neighbors.
We have so many.
And here's 398. So many good things for the young boys to do.
Gross, that's 398, and that's from Hanover Park also. 397 and 398 are both from Hanover Park.
And behind them is another Cub Scout group.
That's 397.
Oh, that's 390s. Yeah. That's 397.
We'll have 399 here, and that's from Streamwood. So we have the whole Cub Scout group represented from Schaumburg, Hoffman Estates, Hanover Park.
Isn't that nice on their sign? It says Cub Scout PAC 397, do your best. And that's all you can ask of somebody.
Aren't they darling? That's wonderful.
And up here is another float. I can't see. Oh, they're fishing.
They're fish, right. Everybody knows fishing is a great pastime.
Oh, it is.
In the United States. And there's Mickey Mouse waving to us and little fireworks.
All my life I've wanted to learn how to fish and I've never done it.
Yes. Yeah. And this is Scout Group 399 from St. Hubert's Parish.
Oh, my. They've got a large contingent.
And they're always here, aren't they?
Yeah. Yes.
Oh, look at their float. A Cub Scout fishing in the 4th of July.
And these are Cub Scouts actually pulling the float.
Yes. Oh, yes. It's a big old wagon.
Isn't that nice?
And the little Cub Scouts are so cute.
Yes. And their leaders are telling them, just walk on the yellow line.
So that it must be very hot to pull that float.
Yes.
You know, and then we have the Girl Scouts of Greater Chicago and Northwest Indiana.
And their leader is a gal named Selena Randecker.
Yes. They have to have the Girl Scouts in there, you know. Do you know, during the 4th of July, we also have picnics. And I've got to tell you some little factoids of the picnic. Please pass a potato salad. Potato salad and potato chips are some of the most popular food items. Approximately half of the nation's potatoes were produced in Idaho or Washington, the state of Washington, in 2010.
Yeah, we all know about Idaho potatoes.
Oh, yes. And more than three-fourths of the lettuce in the United States was produced in California.
I believe it. And yes. That's where our artichokes and our garlic comes from.
Yes. And over the odds that your side dish of baked beans originated from North Dakota is really high. Because
oh, that's interesting.
36% of the nation's dry beans were produced there in 2010.
Oh, that's very interesting.
And another popular 4th of July side dish, corn on the cob, is produced in Florida, California, Georgia, Washington, and New York.
I can't wait till August and we have good old Illinois corn, because no matter where you go, I think that's the sweetest.
Yeah. I just bought some Michigan sweet corn at the farmer's market. But over 68% of sweet corn is produced in those states. Isn't
wow,
that amazing?
Yes.
Yes.
You know, when we were children, long, long time ago, you had foods that were seasonal. Now they're no longer seasonal because they can be brought in from other countries as well as other states.
Yes. The number of states in which the value of the broiler chicken population was $1 billion.
Wow. Is Arkansas still the chief producer of chicken?
Well, Georgia, Arkansas, North Carolina, Alabama, Mississippi, or Texas.
Wow.
Yeah. Yes, and it's a billion-dollar business. Here's some more Girl Scouts here.
Yes.
Coming along in brownies. And, yes. Right. Oh, and then behind them, we have another, I think it's Destiny Church. Let's see. So this is TNT Landscapes Construction Company with their big trucks, and they're from Elgin. They're huge, aren't they?
And they've got flags, lots of beautiful flags. The MIA flag and the American flag.
Then we have St. Alexis Medical Center following them. And it's been a part of our community since 1979.
It first started as Humana Hospital, and then over time it was bought out by the Alexian Brothers system, and they're a wonderful addition to our community.
We also have the building, which is going to be open in 2013, a whole pediatric hospital section, which it will be very, very good. And it's going to be a stage three, level three hospital. Here is their float they have on there that is talking about their children's hospital. And they have a little kid's face up there.
And there's one of the brothers.
Yes, right. They're volunteers. Little baby there walking. Then we have the Hoffman Estates Park District. Again, Scott Trepan, who just passed away recently. He was one of the instrumental people with the Park District.
There's Kaz Mohan.
And he got over.
Thank you, Kaz.
Thank you. He got over $2 million grant money for the village, for the Hoffman Estates. And he also started the Hoffman Estates Parks Foundation. That's Evans, Trustee Evans yes. on there. And two more of the trustees from the Park District. They've done a great deal with the Park District, with all the programs for young people. The Hoffman Estates Foundation, Park District Foundation,
yes.
has provided free programs for children who are unable to pay. They've got money for that. They've just done a whole lot. It's part of the Scott Trepan.
That's his legacy.
Legacy, right. And what they have tried to give back to the community. Isn't it great?
That's lovely. Look at the Crayola box. And there's the
Prince
of Peace.
That's the Arts Commission, Debbie, your Arts Commission. Right there, that truck was your Arts Commission. This is our Schaumburg Township District Library coming up. The float was done by our graphics department, and Maureen Howell is one of the graphic designers there, and she's from our community, along with her husband, who's been valuable in both the village as well as the Park District. Bob Lyons is one of their trustees.
Hi, Lucky.
Lucky is driving. And we have
Where is Bob?
Anita Scott, who's yes. a part of our trustees also, walking along, and our new trustee from
Julie
Bosshart. And we have Judy Napier there with her grandchildren.
And here's the Celebrations Commission of the village, and they're doing a food drive.
Yes, anybody that can, and we have people handing money to them. You can either give money or some food items, and they're getting it. Here's the Public Works Department.
And they're singing.
Wonderful.
Yeah, that's the Public Works. That's the truck we really need in the wintertime.
The band is called the... it's a small brass band that they have there. That was very nice from the Arts Commission. Yeah. Then we have...
I'm proud to be the vice chair of the Arts Commission.
Oh, that's great, Debbie. Then we have State Representative Fred Crespo. His contingent is coming along. here. He's represents parts of Hoffman Estates, Hanover Park, parts of Streamwood too, Deb?
Yes.
Yes.
And a little bit of Schaumburg too, I believe.
Oh, good. And walking with him are a number of his volunteers. We saw him earlier with another contingent.
There's his wife.
Yeah. We have another group of people coming along that fire truck, designating uh-huh. kind of the end of the parade is coming up. It's been a wonderful parade, hasn't it, Debbie?
Oh, it's been marvelous, but I don't think we're near the end yet, are we?
Well, I don't know. We always hear that sign, though. We have a number. We still have to get the township floats
in. That's right.
In, for sure. There is a Fred Crispo. Oh, nice convertible, isn't it?
Yeah.
That's a very nice.
And I haven't seen the Historical Society that I belong to.
Oh,
they have a car here.
And now coming by us is the
mayor
of Hanover Park. Yeah, there
Rod Craig is a great mayor. Great mayor.
He's walking with Fred Crespo. And then we have from the Cook County.
Tim Schneider.
Yeah, and he represents our area. In the county of Cook.
And there he is in the yellow shirt.
Yes, you see him waving right there.
Tim.
Right. Look at the little kid with his dad on that
tractor.
That's
wonderful.
There.
And coming up is Friendship Village. Life is better among friends.
Friendship Village is a retirement community in our area, and it has both retirement living, assisted living, and health care.
It's a very large part of the community.
Yes, it's a beautiful new addition.
Oh, yes, and they have a swimming pool that's Olympic size, that's fabulous, and that's available to citizens. Anybody can go and for a small fee and use their pool and their gym equipment. And I'm pleased to say that Friendship Village is the sole sponsor of Roosevelt University's Institute for Continued Learning lecture series in midwinter.
Oh, that's right, Deb. We have...
I can't read the sign of that car. It's a police car of some sort.
We have a number of police cars that are now...
Oh, that's from Madison.
Yes.
No. Waterman Police.
This year we've had fire department and police cars interchanged with incorporated in the actual parade.
Yeah, it used to be they'd be a separate thing on their own.
In the
but
very
now,
beginning.
Yeah,
right.
Now it's just all mixed up. I kind of like that better.
Yeah, you get to be able to tell who's coming from where.
Right. Except the noise.
Exactly.
Oh, you at home watching, I don't know if you can hear, but the noise from those police cars was intense.
Oh, yes. But it's part of the ambiance of the parade.
Oh, it is. It's wonderful.
Here we have another float coming up with it. A lot of microphones this year.
A lot of loudspeakers on the floats.
Yeah.
More than usual.
Yeah.
But that's okay. They make their presence known.
Yes.
And that's a good thing to do.
The Schaumburg... club that handles all of the parade, amateur radio group. He's packing up now, but we always want to thank them because they keep the parade and us informed.
Oh, absolutely.
About it. All right, here comes the Coolidge Community Band.
Where are they from, Barbara?
They're from Madison, Illinois. Madison, Illinois. Isn't that a nice band? A jazz band. Don's July 4th.
Drive safe, walk safe, drink safe.
It's Dan's July 4th band.
And right behind them is the Slaughter. And they play at the Sears Center Arena all the time. They're just a wonderful, wonderful indoor football team.
And we learned, isn't that the one that's done by
Jim McMahon?
Jim McMahon, yeah, and from the former quarterback for the Bears. Here's a village of Streamwood, I believe. Chrysler.
Bigger Chevrolet.
Oh, having the Slaughter's coach right there.
Oh, okay.
He's carrying the Slaughter coach. And that's great.
Oh, look at him.
It's one of the Slaughter football coaches.
Coming up now is Church of the Cross in Hoffman Estates. They've been around for a long time as well.
Right. Oh, they have nice music there.
Yes, and they've got a truck with a running board the kids are standing on to throw candy. Very few vehicles have running boards, but they found one.
Also, Steve McMichael, Mongo, and that's who that guy was dressed up like, Mongo, is the team coach.
Oh, nice.
And they just finished their fifth season at the Sears Arena. And that's their mascot, Sarge. That was there.
And you can always visit their website to learn more about them. They're at www.chicagoslaughter.com. And it might be worth doing when you've got nothing else to do. Look them up and read about them, because they're now an important part of our village.
They're our hometown professional indoor football team, Deb.
Yep, and here come the Knights of Columbus, the Hoffman Estates, Schaumburg, Council 684. Oh, they're the peanut people.
Yes. Yes.
Oh, look at their costumes. They're wonderful.
That's the highest order of the knights in the purple.
Yes.
There's Mr. Amrine is part of them over there. I see Mr. Amrine.
Oh, he is a very, very nice guy.
Yeah. And they, like you said, they have the Tootsie Rolls that they pass out on the, part of gathering money for their work with the disabled.
They do a wonderful job.
Then we have the coming up float. Again, we've gotten a little out of place, but on this we have the Morning Star Recordings.
They play original patriotic music from the CD America, and was a WGN radio star group.
And the American taxi cabs that we take so much from the train station and around here.
I take them all the time when I need a taxi.
And then we have Spectrum, which is part of the Schaumburg Township. And it's for the youth, and it's one of the finest places to go. Jerry Lips is the director of that for the township.
There's a young man, has his face painted like a flag.
Yes, yes. Behind them, we have the rest, some more of the township floats. We have the senior services, which provides and disabled services, which provides a van that they'll pick up somebody at their home and bring them.
I can't rave enough about them.
No.
They pick my husband up 3 times a week and take him to and from dialysis. It's an absolutely extraordinary service. And we feel blessed to live in an area that has that.
And the township
assessor John Lawson, is there. And he gets inundated when people get their tax bills. He gets inundated with a lot of complaints.
Supervisor for the township is Mary Wobuleski. Trustees are Diana Dunton, Scott Kegaris, yes. Robert Vintage, and clerk Tim Hennigan.
And trustee Bob Vintage is an old friend, a wonderful friend of mine.
Highway Commissioner is Robert Fercott.
Fecaron. Oh, that, and the township is... Bob Ficarota brings out the sheriff's guys every January or February for free car washes.
We had the Palatine for the seniors, right, and disabled?
Anybody can get a free car wash. Just line up. It'll be in the newspaper.
Palatine,
and it's great.
Township Food Pantry is here.
Yes.
That's the first time for that one.
And a beautiful truck, Stop Hunger, and a stop sign.
And the Christian Tabernacle Church is coming. It's a church without walls. They have them all over. They come to different, where do they have their, at a school, I think.
Yeah,
it's
I think so.
Eisenhower Junior High, that they have their church services. Yeah. They're in. They have a beautiful choir that comes to a number of things.
Oh, that's nice.
Right. And then we have, coming up, we have Massage Envy, which
There's something in front, though. There's a car. I can't read, Barbara.
Okay. That should be the Christian...
no, that's Schaumburg Township Historical Society.
Oh,
and
yes.
It's driven by Marty Neville and his wife. Thank you. Same to you.
Oh, the historical. Yes, that's part of your belong to that too.
Yes, I'm a life member. And this is Massage Envy in Hoffman Estates. And that's a great name for a massage parlor.
Behind them is the Mercedes-Benz dealership. And that is the teen.
Miss Jean Hoffman
Cook
Estates.
County. No, it's
Cook County?
Cook County, yes. She's a lovely young person.
She looks lovely.
She's preteen, outstanding preteen.
Oh,
and
nice.
She comes to a whole lot of public affairs. She's really taken that seriously.
Oh, that's good.
Well, it's a great parade again. I hope everybody enjoyed it. The weather really cooperated, and it seemed like everybody's having a really good time, and it'll continue for the rest of the day.
Yeah, come on to the village hall. Fun activities.
Yeah, come to the festival. I know that, I think it's 1 o'clock, there's bingo. I was eyeing that one.
Oh, yes.
Yeah, there's entertainment, there's all sorts of things to do.
Good food.
Come on down, have a good time. Same time next year.
Yes.
Thank you.
We loved your bagpiper.
Oh, that really made it.
Oh, yes. It was beautiful. Okay, now we had the Village of Schaumburg's truck.
Yes.
Who's coming along, and they're always so nice. Mayor Larson. And his trustees, which Marge Conley, Hank
Curcio,
George Dunham, Frank Kozak,
Mark Madge,
and Jack Sullivan, and then the village clerk, Marilyn Carr is the village clerk. We have Rohrman Carr here.
Bob Rohrman Chevrolet.
Right, with the wonderful convertible. And
that's the Village of Schaumburg also. Right. Mayor Al Larson car.
Right. And they're all walking along, passing out candy. Yeah. Thank you.
Oh, thank you very much. Wonderful. Oh, you're a doll. Thanks.
And then we have some more of the village here. The Public Works Department from Schaumburg. We're in their parades, they're in our parades.
They have wonderful Septemberfest parade that
our village participates in. We have all of their trucks now all together, their cars all together, just like before. We'll have a fire truck from there. That's interesting that that's how it was organized today.
I don't understand that. I would have thought they'd be up to the top of the parade.
And then we have a coming up, Vicious Apparel.
Isn't that an interesting name?
Yes, right. And they support local charities throughout the community.
You know what we didn't have this year? We didn't have the Shriners on the little bikes.
No, we didn't. You're right. Here he is cleaning the car here while they pick up more candy. Yes, here we go. And this is called Ron and Joe. And they're dispensing happiness to the residents of Hoffman Estates.
They're just a couple of people who wanted to be in the parade and share the joy.
Yeah.
This is Vicious Apparel.
It's a local clothing company dedicating to helping the community. They've helped in a park in Streamwood, churches, nonprofit organizations.
I wonder what they do.
They're very active in the local music scene, and they have, they're playing right now alternative music. And the three of, they have a website that they have and you can go to. And let me see, what else do we know about this?
Their website is just viciousapparel.com. I think I'm going to look when I get home because it's an intriguing name for a group.
Right.
And behind them is an Avon car.
And that's Connie Sorella.
And if you haven't tried Avon products, you really ought to. They're quite good. High quality.
And there she is. Oh, no. Now at the end, we have Algren and Sons Funeral Home. And that's one of our oldest funeral establishments.
It's one of the oldest companies in the village. And it's one place you want to see in a parade, not elsewhere.
Well, it's something to remind you. Don't drink and drive.
Absolutely.
And watch your drinking during the 4th of July Fest. You don't want to be visiting the funeral home.
It's too easy to guzzle down lots and lots of beer when it's a hot day like this.
And they'd say, congratulations to Julie Clark. They're representing her for the Schomburg-Hoffman Estates Rotary Club.
That's another service group that does an awful lot for the people in the community. Right. And last is the fire department, not least.
Is our Hoffman Estates Fire Department. It's been a wonderful, wonderful parade.
Yes, it has.
And we thank the Public Works Department. Pete Olinger, who is the organizer for the parade, all of the Village 4th of July Commission, which is a lot of work.
And Bruce Anderson and his group for the cable televising this.
Yeah, they do a wonderful job.
And before we leave you, I just want to echo something the mayor said. It's a wonderful day. The sun is shining. It's not terribly, terribly hot. It's a good day to go to the festival on the village. The village hall grounds.
There's something for everyone there, from bingo to pony rides for the children to other rides. That's our civil defense van there. And they take care of it like when there is a flood.
They're there
making sure that we're all safe. Again, thank you for joining us. This is the 50th parade, anniversary of the parades in Hoffman Estates. Even though we celebrated our 50th anniversary over a year ago, this is our 50th parade.
And this is Barbara Adrianopoli and Debbie Miller, your hosts for the parade.
And we thank you very much. And we thank Bruce Anderson and his crew for the cabling of this program and the Village of Hoffman Estates, Public Works, Police, Fire Department, Health and Human Services. They're all really professionals who help make this village a wonderful success that it is. And the Senior Commission and the 4th of July Commission, who puts this big production on. Pete Olinger, like I said, does the parade route with all the entries. And Sue Lesson puts it all together in a wonderful, wonderful book that we've been using. So we thank all of them and have a wonderful 4th of July. Our pleasure.
That was fun.